Okay, guys, you know what that means. It's time to talk about Super H Heroes. Super H X Heroes Episode 5, or Go Go Hentai Rangers. Once again. Now, we're going on Episode 5 now, and I gotta say, it's really about the building of, the character building of the Yellow Ranger herself. I mean, I get it, she's one of those tsundere girls that don't open up. But in this case, it's rare to see a tsundere girl open up. I mean, think about it. How often do you guys see a tsundere girl open up to a main character emotions? I mean, not really that much. Especially in a harem ecchi anime like this. It's hard for a character to be open. They don't show it, but they do it sometimes. So, while she got captured, you know, the other rangers are setting out to save her. Now, to do that, in case of situations, they have to build up their H energy. Because remember, they use it in their last battle. So how do they build up their super H energy in this one? By doing everything pervertedly just to get their powers. First step, get rid of their panties. And they gave all three of them to our main hero herself. Props to the main hero for doing that. Now, here's the thing. That scene where Momozono was fingering herself in the bed. You know, it's funny how I bring that up, because the last time I saw that kind of scene was Hina in Domestic Girlfriend. You know, if you have watched Domestic Girlfriend, understand that scene where Hina was on the bed fingering herself. That's that. And I think that was the last time I saw that, where a girl in the anime fingering herself. That right there was an example. But I'm like, wow, they really bring that up. And I'm like, wow, I'm feeling some Domestic Girlfriend Hina vibe in the bed. It was funny. So while they traveling from train to bus to cab, all transportation, get to the nearest base, they had to do so many etchy ways to get there. For example, getting on a train where Momozono got her, sliding on the pole right here. Her breasts, girls with the big breasts, you know, on the wall and one butt cheeks on the thing. You know, anything to increase their itchiness, I don't care. As long as it's a way to bring the energy. Now for our Yellow Ranger. As she escaped, she met the girl named Cha-Cha. Cha-Cha is the princess of the mother herself, the queen of all things evil. I look at Cha-Cha and she got, I'm not saying she's hot, but what I'm trying to say is, she's, you know, it's like, I felt the, like, I don't know if I want to, like, no, I don't want her as best girl, like, waifu material. I mean, yeah, she got the eyes, the hair, not the body, because the body, like, I can't. The thing about harem animes, still, this is true, the thing about harem animes, any harem girl that is about this tall, I can't see that as a waifu material. I see that as a daughter slash sister type way, like Kusuno from Sekirei, or the girl from High School DxD with the rook, the girl who kicks it. I forgot her name, but the cat girl, yeah, but her, for example, you know, in the succubus thing from Shumano Testament, characters like that, I can't, because I see them as a sister slash daughter type of way. So when I looked at Cha-Cha, I can't. Although she did some perverted stuff for the Yellow Ranger to increase her thing, although that was really nice scenes with that we get to see, it wasn't enough. For you see, the Yellow Ranger herself, she's in that tsundere mode that expressed the feelings. That's why her powers hasn't been like functioning, because she's not really open. You know, just if you're gonna defend the world, be open with one true self. Be open and just let out and just blast the motherfuckers out the sky. Now as our heroes running through the cave, they did their powers, and we get to see some nudity. However, it's censored. Now I know that it's hard for us. I know it's hard deep down in us that we want to see uncensoredness. But like I said, we're on episode 5. Give it episode 6 or 7, we're bound to see it happen. Now, as they're trying to save, you know, her, she got captured. Not only that, Cha-Cha was fighting back. But even though she's the princess, there's not much to do for her. Now, as for our main hero, he gave up his H energy morpher. I call it the morphers. Each of them has a morpher around. I call them morphers. Gave them their morphers, dropped it, surrendered himself. And that kind of triggers the Yellow Ranger point plot. That called plot. Like, if it wasn't for her, if it wasn't for him dropping his morpher, he would have done, like, come on. We all know he's all pee already with one punch. Saitama would have been proud. And, but like I said, I'm not saying, but but you get the point. So it gave us another flashback of them talking, you know, in the rain. And looking back on every episode, there's going to be a point where we're going to see, like, flashback to this, flashback to this, flashback to this, and we're going to get a lot. And I'm going to see that happening. It's going to point out every little detail about it. Just for the Yellow Ranger to increase her energy. And that's going to be focusing on that. Like, I get it that they're going to focus every main character, but prior to that, they're going to focus on Yellow Ranger herself, compared to the Red Ranger. So after that one punch out of the nowhere land, no man's land, Cha-Cha was about to be destroyed by her own ship, but leave it to our main hero to save her. Now, at the end of the episode, this is where things get a little saucy. In the episode, they get saved, Cha-Cha saved, but we found out that she's, like, really hot. Like, literally, like, normal human type, dark skin with a good body, like everything, you know? Like, damn, she's freaking hot. Now, the thing is, here's the thing, and I don't know why. And I'm sure you guys understand this. Would you guys smash or pass her? I mean, like, the new girl, Cha-Cha. Like, here's the thing. If you're into the cat ears type thing, like Cat Planet Cuties, I can understand that. But here's the thing. Cha-Cha's, like, this tall. But that's her form. You know what I mean? Like, I don't know. I mean, it's like, you want to smash her, but at the same time, she's, like, this level, you know what I mean? Like, she's this height, but she's that, and I don't know if that's her true form, like this height is true form or this, but honestly, I just don't know. And now, not only she's the new roommate, she's also gonna be supporting the Rangers to increase their H energy, meaning we got a perverted girl added to the mix as his harem group. Think about it, you got a tsundere Yellow Ranger, you got a flat chested tomboyish girl who don't care about the odds. You got a little girl who's shy, not shy, but, you know, showing she like to draw a lot. You got one who's shy, big-breasted shy girl, who's like the big sister of the group. And now you got a perverted cat on that side. Now you got a perverted catty, and well, not an insect, I'm gonna call it insect, that catty or something. But yeah, you got a perverted, can't say that. Let's just say you got a friend, a companion on your side. And that's I'm going to say cat ears anyway. But, and then you got, and now the dog thing, I think it's going to be some dog versus cat action when they, if they were to get to that route. But now that she lived with them, she's going to be the supporter of, to support their H energy. Meaning, we're going to see a lot of dosage of her trying to get in his pants and trying to get to everybody's panties, if you know what I mean. Just increase the H energy. So, I look forward for next week's episode in the long run. Like I said before in my other videos when I did the God of High School, this will be my final week. So, I was here for one more week. So, this is the final week. You know what I mean? So, thank you for watching. And as the episode progresses, I will give you guys a recap of how I felt from watching Super H Heroes up to the latest ones. So, let's stay true to our itchiness energies and let's make sure that our main hero and our heroes can conquer the world one itchiness at a time.